In the last few years, Game Pass has been praised for its value. It has a library of amazing games, including first-party Microsoft games. The only problem is, it doesn't work on the Steam Deck. You can leverage cloud gaming or install Windows, but you can't play games natively on SteamOS. Today I want to talk about a value that's almost as good or maybe even better because it actually works on Deck, just like I work on Deck. I work hard every week to tell you what's new on Steam Deck. If you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to hit the like button. It helps this video reach more people. And if you're still unsubscribed, then hi, my name is Richard, and I love the Steam Deck. If you do too, subscribe and slap the bell. Okay, so what is this mysterious deal I'm talking about? Have you guessed it yet? Here's a hint. I'm referring to another subscription with AAA games just like Game Pass. If that doesn't give it away, I'm talking about EA Play. This is not an ad, but I didn't realize the value of this subscription until recently, and it seems that you all haven't either. It's $5 a month, and you get a rack of games that are playable from Steam as opposed to needing the Origin launcher. I had EA Play with Game Pass, but I don't think I fully realized the value because I've been burned by EA in the past, and I'm not gonna lie, I didn't really want to deal with a whole other launcher. In any case, I know that EA has made really good strides as of late, but I never stopped to take stock of all the bangers that they've been dropping. What got me to really notice EA Play this time was one of you folks. My dude Scarface asked me to test Madden, and to be honest, I haven't actually played a Madden game in a minute. Madden 22 was on sale, so I almost bought that, but then I saw EA Play was $5 for a month or $30 for the year. It includes a 10-hour trial of Madden 22 and a 10-hour trial of Grid Legends. 10 hours was more than what I needed for Madden, so I did the thing. And yeah, it turns out Madden 22 plays great on Steam Deck. There is an initial launcher install for Origin, but it's mostly seamless and never requires you to go to desktop mode or anything like that. All of EA's requests for your data were annoying, but they're unticked by default, so they get points for that. When using the default settings, the game reaches 60 FPS easily while using up about 20 total watts, so you can get 2 hours of battery life. From there, you can tweak the settings however you like to get more battery life or to up the graphics a little bit. Overall, if you were looking to play Madden on Steam Deck, you are in good shape. Beyond the trials for Madden and Grid Legends, I started taking advantage of the full games on EA Play. There's the recent Star Wars stuff like Squadrons and Jedi Fallen Order, there's a ridiculous amount of quality racers from the Codemasters crew, there's Knockout City, which is fun as hell, FIFA 22 has a 10-hour trial but FIFA 21 is available in full, BioWare games from the Mass Effect remaster all the way back to Jade Empire, and there's Super Mega Baseball 3, which is wildly underrated and might be the best baseball game ever. I also only own Titanfall 2 on Origin, so I like that I can now easily play it on Steam Deck using EA Play. And I'm just impressed that number one, all of this is available within Steam. You do need to install Origin, but it all happens inside of the Steam Deck gaming mode. Number two, EA Play has a Steam specific feature where it asks you if you want to create an EA Play collection and shelf within Steam. I like that they're thinking about Steam specific things like that. And finally, most important number three, these are generally games that are playable on Steam Deck. EA clearly cares about Steam and the Steam Deck as a platform, and they are surprisingly one of the top partners of Valve's handheld. This is in contrast to the current state of Game Pass. Microsoft is clearly betting big on xCloud and the future of streaming games, but I would really, really like it if Game Pass on Steam was a real thing. It's something that a lot of us have asked for, and it was just a couple months ago that Gabe himself said that he's open to it. In an interview with PC Gamer, he said, quote, "We've talked to people there quite a bit about this topic. If your customers want it, then you should figure out how to make it happen. That's where we're at." End quote. So yeah, it would be great if Microsoft could hop on the bandwagon and make it so that we can all enjoy more of the Game Pass benefits on Steam Deck. By the way, do you know how I realized that many of you weren't taking advantage of this subscription? It Takes Two was recently in the Steam top sellers 2 weeks in a row. Deservedly so, mind you, but it means that you all were buying the game instead of using EA Play. Admittedly, that's not empirical evidence, and I'm super happy that people are buying It Takes Two. But yeah, it kind of goes to show that there are a lot of gamers that are perhaps overlooking EA Play. And for what it's worth, I have major concerns about a subscription model for games, including Game Pass. I remember the value that Netflix had back in its heyday. Apparently, Netflix had the most content it's ever had back in 2012. The following year, Netflix lost nearly 2,000 titles from its library. Back in 2012, the subscription was also only $8 a month, and we were upset that we could no longer rent DVDs in that 1 month plan. Remember that? Remember how mad we were that we could no longer get one DVD per month in the mail? Good times. So in the last 10 years, we've lost a bunch of content and the price has gone up. So clearly the value is not the same. That's a bit of an oversimplification, but suffice it to say, I do expect that the same will eventually happen to Game Pass and yes, even EA Play. The price of these subscription models will go up, the amount of content will go down, and of course you won't own any of the content you didn't actually buy over the years. That's fine, but you should know what you're getting into. I bought a 1-year subscription of EA Play for $30 because I think it's going to come in handy for the channel. But if it weren't for that, I wouldn't necessarily expect to stay on the subscription for months and months. And if I really, really like a game, I'm going to want to buy it and have it in my library. For those of you that are similar, I do have a couple of other suggestions. First of all, be sure to utilize your Steam wishlist. If you're new to Steam, you may not know that it has an awesome wishlist built in. You can add games to your wishlist and then go to your wishlist to filter and sort so you can easily see what's on sale. Steam will also send you emails or notifications when items on your wishlist do go on sale. If you want this, but on steroids, then you should use a price tracker because there are many online stores that sell Steam games like Green Man Gaming and HumbleBundle.com. I recommend gg.deals or isthereanydeal.com. These will sync with your Steam wishlist and you can set up advanced alerts like only notify me when a game reaches a new historical low price. These deal trackers can also let you know when a game you want is included in a bundle, of which there are plenty. I am subscribed to the monthly bundle from Humble. It's called Humble Choice. I like it because you get to keep the games in the bundle as opposed to PS Plus or Game Pass or games with gold. And if I don't like the options of a particular month, I can just pause it with no additional cost to me. The only thing to be aware of when buying Steam games from non-Steam stores is that they don't have the same refund policy that Steam has. Sometimes the discount is worth it, but if you want to keep the option to return a game hassle-free, you should stick to buying games on Steam. Some people have asked if Steam points can be used on games, and no, they cannot, but Steam has its own robust ecosystem. If you have enough time on your hands, you can earn some pennies just by playing the games that you're already playing. Here's how it works. Each game you own has trading cards, up to 8 unique ones, and by playing the game, you can receive half the total, up to 4. Technically, you don't have to actually play the game, only have the game open or convince the Steam servers that the game is running. Given a name, you can actually trade these cards, or more to the point, you can sell these cards on the Steam marketplace. Typically, they only go for pennies, but sometimes you'll get a card that's more rare or a booster pack. So if you play enough games, this can all add up and go towards your next game purchase. So yeah, those are some tips for saving some coin on Steam. I think the EA Play option is nice for what it provides, especially if you're new to PC gaming. This gives you the option to test a wide variety of games on your brand new Steam Deck, and even the 10-hour trials are helpful. I'd much rather they be the full games like on Game Pass, but that's okay. And if you prefer indies, they have Fee, Unravel, Sea of Solitude, and It Takes Two. The only thing I would say is missing is a healthy retro library. I think that's unrealistic for EA, whose retro library is marred with licensing issues, but it would be really cool to play the original SimCity, the original Syndicate, or even some good old NBA Live 95 online with friends. And if you're not cool with the subscription model, then hopefully the other tips I provided could be of use to you. And if you can't get enough video games, be sure to check out my last video where I spotlight 5 new hidden gems. They're freaking awesome. Alright, deck gang out. Goodbye!